Let's see one-to-one correspondence technique, which is sometimes, you know, helpful in solving some of the counting problems. So what is one-to-one correspondence is, let's say you have two sets, let's say set of boys and set of girls, okay. So this is girl set and this is boy set, let's say, okay. Now, so what is one-to-one correspondence is, somehow if every boy can be mapped to some girl like this, and every girl also mapped to exactly one boy like this, then we say there is a one-to-one correspondence between these two sets. This is, let's say, boy set and this is girl set. So try to understand the meaning of one-to-one correspondence. For every boy there is a mapping girl, and for every girl there is a mapping boy. Then always you end with this kind of structure: for every boy you see one girl, and for every girl you see one boy. Then you can understand that automatically number of boys equal to number of girls, correct? So that is one important property of one-to-one correspondence. Whenever I keep one-to-one correspondence between two sets, then it is like proving that these two sets are equal. The advantage of doing of this one is, let's say you have a problem which is not solved up to now, and there is another problem which is S, and you know how to solve it. That means you know number of solutions of this problem, let's say S1, S2, S3, and you don't know the number of solutions of this problem, but you know that there is a one-to-one correspondence between the solutions of problem P and solutions of problem S, let's say. Then with this concept you can say that number of solutions of problem P also equal to number of problems of solution S. Since you know this number of solutions, example here 3, then automatically this also should become 3. So this is called reducing a problem to one problem to another problem, correct? So for that we use a technique called one-to-one correspondence technique. Let me ask you one fundamental question here about natural numbers and even numbers. Let me write natural numbers first. Natural numbers are 1, 2, 3, so on, and even numbers are 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on, okay. Now the question is, the size of natural numbers and size of even numbers are nothing but the number of elements in the corresponding sets. So the question is, are they equal? Otherwise, are they not equal? So most of the students think that natural numbers are, you know, bigger than even numbers, right? It looks like, at least, you know. So we are deceived by the set appearance, correct? So what I want to say is, here natural numbers actually not bigger than even numbers with respect to size. I prove that already. We know that if there is a one-to-one correspondence between two sets, that two sets should be equal, isn't it? Then I use same technique to prove that natural numbers equal to even numbers with respect to size. How I do it is, I take natural numbers at one side and even numbers at other side. Example, natural numbers at this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on, and even numbers at this side, 2, 4, 6, 8, so on, and I show you one-to-one correspondence between them. So for that, formula is, any element I belongs to natural number and should be exactly, should be put into one-to-one correspondence with E, which is nothing but 2 into I. So what I am doing is, I am putting a one-to-one correspondence between n comma e using I to 2i mapping. Okay, so I is mapped to 2i. Whenever I do that, so 1 will be mapped to 2, 2 will be mapped to 4, and 3 will be mapped to 6, and 4 will be mapped to 8, 5 will be mapped to 10. So if you observe that every natural number is exactly mapped to one element, even number. And every even number also is exactly mapped to one natural number with this method. So there is a one-to-one correspondence. So all the natural numbers are exactly have an image at even number set, correct or not? So we say that there is a one-to-one correspondence. The number of ends at this side equal to number of ends at this side. If you have one element at this end, then there is a corresponding element at other end, isn't it? If that is the case, number of ends are equal, then number of elements supposed to be equal, then natural number should be equal to even numbers. So this is absolutely right. But you know, most of the time we believe that, you know, natural numbers are, you know, bigger than even numbers. That's absolutely false. So this is the usage of the powerful technique called one-to-one correspondence technique. Okay, we will see one more problem: the number of subsets of a set of n elements. Okay, so how I solve this problem is, first I take n value 3 and I understand the problem. Like, when you have 3 elements, then the subsets are like set 1, set 2, right, set 3 and set 1, 2, so on, correct? I don't write all, I'm just understanding what are the typical solutions for this problem. After that, I put a one-to-one correspondence between these subsets and code words. I'm going to design a code word with 3 positions. You can easily understand what does it mean. Okay, so what I do is I take 3 positions. Since in this subset, especially element 1 is present, in the position number 1 I write 1. Since other elements are not present, then I write zeros. That's why. So easily you can understand the corresponding code word. Now by this time you also got the idea how to generate a code word, isn't it? So for this set 2, it will be 0, 1, 0, because this position represents element 2. Okay. Now similarly, set 1, 2, I write. Set 1, 2 is nothing but position 1, 1, position 2, 1, and position 3, 0. So in that way, every subset has a code word, right? A unique code word. Every subset has a code word which is different from others. You can understand that. And every code word, whatever the code word you take, example code word is 1, 1, 1, still it represents a subset, isn't it so? Then I can say that there is a one-to-one correspondence between subsets, comma code words. But code words are already known, right? The total number of code words are nothing but total number of binary sequences with 3 positions. How many binary sequences are possible with 3 positions? 2 power 3. Exactly, the number of subsets also should be 2 power 3. The reason, one-to-one correspondence technique. One-to-one correspondence technique proves that 2 sets are equal, right? So now this is the idea. But in general, we have n elements. When you have n elements, then this 1, 2, 3 will become 1, 2, 3, so on n. Then the number of subsets, I don't know which is to be calculated, but number of code words are 2 to the power of n, because you have to take n positions and binary sequences. So how many binary sequences possible with n positions is 2 to the power of n. Then number of subsets also 2 to the power of n. In that way, we can effectively use one-to-one correspondence technique to solve some problems. Okay, so keep solving problems related to this one-to-one correspondence technique so that you can master it.